Today I'm fitting polyurethane bushing as replacements for the stock Saab 9-3 front wishbone bushes. In particular, I'm changing this rear bush, the one that has the most control over the fore aft movement of the wheel and therefore has the most influence over the car's ability to resist axle tramp. I'll show you how to fit this bush and I'll explain to you how to fit the front bush, although I'm not doing a PU bush in that position. I'm happy with the standard bush here. If, like me, you're replacing the old arm because it has a knackered ball joint, then you will need to remove the arm from the car. I have done a video about how to do that, which I'll link in the description. If you're replacing both bushes with poly, again you will need to remove the arm. If, like me, you're only fitting a new bush to the rear of the Saab 9-3 front wishbone, then you can do that with the arm still on the car. Some additional information to the wishbone removal video. You'll almost certainly find that the ball joint is a pain in the proverbials to remove from the steering knuckle. In the video, I showed using a drift to spread the knuckle and the ball joint should drop out. It doesn't always work out that way though. If you find yourself with that problem, release the front and rear bushes from the subframe, drop the inner end of the wishbone down, and you should find it's now much easier to get the shaft out of the steering knuckle. To remove the rear bush from the wishbone, undo and remove this screw with a 14 or 15 millimeter socket, and the bush should slide off the shaft at the rear of the wishbone. New wishbones are supplied with the bush ready fitted and torqued to the arm. So if you're replacing the arm with the standard bushes, then fit it as supplied. If you're fitting a new bush to your existing arm, make sure you put the cone in place and your bush this side on first. Fit the screw and torque it up to 30 Newton meters plus 40 degrees. To convert the rear bush to polyurethane, you'll need to remove the entire bush from the wishbone as already shown, and then you'll need to take the bush to a shop with a press and have them press the inner bush out of the aluminium housing. Press it from the end with the thicker wall. Once you've got the bush out, you can see that there's a step halfway down the housing. Clean the inside of the housing down with a wire brush and a drill, and then wash it out with brake cleaner. The bushes come with a little pouch of silicone grease, so apply some to the inside of the housing. Making sure the new bush is clean, fit it into the housing. It might be a tight fit if it's new. If you look down the inside of the bush, you'll see that there's a crisscross pattern down the middle. That's there to hold grease into place to lubricate to the centre steel support tube. So apply silicone grease down the centre of the bush and then fit the support tube. Lubricate the countersink in the bush, fit the cone to the arm and then the bush to the arm. Lubricate the end of the bush and then fit and torque up the screw. New arms come ready fitted with a standard front bush. If you wish to swap that for a poly bush, then you will need to have it pressed out of the arm at the same time as you're having the rear bush pressed out of its housing. The arm should now rotate freely inside the bush. A disadvantage of polyurethane bushes is that compared to their stock rubber counterparts, they are not fit and forget. I suggest taking the bushes off once a year, cleaning and re-lubricating them. As you can see from this bush, I left this one too long before taking it off and putting fresh lube on, and that allowed some wear to set in. If you got value from this video, please consider supporting the channel in some way, and I shall see you next time.